Hi, I'm Mark, and today I'll be bringing you a review of the Samsung Galaxy A3 smartphone. The A3 came out in December 2014 and is a mid-range smartphone retailing at around £230. The A3 has a nice simple design and sits really comfortably in your hand. On one side of it you'll find a lock button and slots to enter your nano SIM card or micro SD card. On the base you'll find a micro USB port and a headphone socket, and on the other side you'll find the volume controls. The A3 is impressively light to hold, weighing in at just 110 grams. It's also very thin, although this does mean that the camera sticks out a little bit on the back. The phone has a 1.2 GHz quad-core processor with 1.5 GB of RAM. It comes with 16 GB built-in memory, and you can expand that by a further 64 GB using a micro SD card. The phone has built-in Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, NFC, and is both 3G and 4G ready. The A3 has a 4.5-inch QHD Super AMOLED display. This looks really nice and is pretty responsive as well. Battery life on the A3 is fairly decent, and they say it's got about 12 hours talk time. On top of that, Samsung have bundled a load of battery saving options to help you get the most out of that battery when you need it to. Realistically though, you'll still be charging your phone about once a day. As with most smartphones, you'll find two cameras. The front-facing camera is a 5-megapixel camera, which is great for a front-facing camera and ideal for selfies and Snapchat. It also has a function which allows you to hold your hand up to the screen to enable it to automatically take a photo after 2 seconds. The rear-facing camera is a slightly more impressive 8-megapixel camera with flash, and it seems to take fairly decent photos. That rear camera is also capable of taking full HD video. The Galaxy A3 runs Android KitKat, which is easy to get used to whether you've used Android before or not. The built-in apps make it easy to make calls, send messages, browse the internet, manage your diary, and get directions to places. The media apps also make it easy for you to browse your photos, listen to your music, and watch videos. You also have access to both the Galaxy App Store and the Google Play Store, which gives you access to loads of new apps, allowing you to do anything from checking your giffgaff balance to playing games to pass the time. Overall for the price, I think the Samsung Galaxy A3 is really good value, and in particular I was impressed at the design of it and the lightness of the phone. For those reasons, I will give the phone a 7 out of 10. I hope you found this review helpful, and I'll see you guys again soon.